And what safety features do the bikes and also the scooters have?
The safety features is that you know, riding a scooter is probably easier than riding a bike. And one of the main safety features is we can cap the speed at 25 kilometers per hour. Mm. You can't go beyond that. And it will be used using your mobile phone, and it can be linked to like GCash or Maya. Yeah. And then you will just be charged with how many minutes you've used it. So and then in the app, we will also require that helmet should be worn.
And I mean, how long usually is this battery operated? Is this rechargeable?
It's battery operated. So for the scooter, for example, it can last 50 kilometers for a single charge. So it's probably 2 days of use in Ubulus Banos. And it's battery swappable. So the user will not worry about running out of charge, because mm-hmm. we have a technician that goes around and swap the batteries. If it's less than 20%, then a new battery will be swapped for the electric bike and electric e-scooters.
Now, I know you're starting the pilot program, I guess, in UPLB in the first quarter of 2024.
Yes, that's right.
How do you make sure, I guess, that the bikes, the scooters remain within that vicinity?
Okay, that's a very good question. So we have this capability to kind of a geofence. We can establish an area where you can only use the service. If you go out of the area, we will send notification on the phone that you're out of the area, so you have to go back. Otherwise, we can pursue you with the police, just assuming that you have an ill intention of taking the bike. And it has GPS features, no? So even if like bad actors will get the bike or scooters, we can trace where the bike and scooters will be.
Lastly, Arnold, I guess, expansion plans, aside from UPLB, where do you see Tepaklong, I guess, accommodating or addressing those issues, whether it's the traffic? Do you see it mostly in schools, communities, I guess, areas, walkable cities in Manila, Makati, BGC?
Our core strategy is to start with, you know, campuses, industrial park, self-contained townships, or large government complexes. No, think about Camp Aguinaldo. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of a secured, at least. And then when we have finished that kind of market segment, then we go to the, you know, business districts, because we want to perfect this first in this secured environment before we go outside. No? And then, of course, thinking about, for example, tourist areas, no? That we can offer this service as well.
And thank you so much, Arnold Bufi of Tepaklong. Thank you so much for sharing your thoughts. And we're so excited to actually see this in UPLB. Yeah.
Thanks, Denise, for having us here.
Thank you.
Thank you.